Up and welcome to Firewatch. We're gonna begin new game. You don't need to see those. I have played a bit or a lot of the game. We're actually realizing that I haven't recorded it. So yeah. Here we go. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. Alright! It's a... You see Julia? Yes. Thank you. Cue the epic music. She's about your age. Late 20s. Laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk. So what's your major? Yeah. You slur the word mage and it smells like cores. You give an awkward smile. Evolutionary biology, she says, and I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's yours, she asks you. She sniffs the air. Toxicology. Cruel! Mean. Was that a burn, you ask? She says, definitely. Where has she hurt your feelings, she asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. Won't be clear. Or Julia's boyfriend. Yeah, boy! Yeah, give me a bit. Alright, I did. When I first played this, I did walk up there. Okay. Yeah, make sure it's in there. You date for over a year. It drives you absolutely nuts. It's great! It's wonderful! It's peaceful. You move in. You share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Alright. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle Julia is in love with. She wants to bring it with her to class. There is also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking the dog. It's badass! Ooh, naming mayhem. Ugh. I hate this one because both the dogs die. I'll go for Bucket. Bucket's a good dog. A week later, you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him. You love him too. Oh, why isn't there option to adopt both? You talk out on the deck. It's summer at 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off of the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. Kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple of little idiots, that would be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that. You say, yeah, you don't want your kids to be bastards. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best for their parents are hitched. You say, she's absolutely right. And I'm out here in the wild. Looking at how beautiful this game is. Alright. This game is so beautiful. It's true. It's Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call you. You are worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You ignore her. You don't touch each other all night. The next day, you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. You hold on to a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You pose and flirt like a He-Man. You thread it like a Victoria's Secret model. That one sounds humorous. That one sounds funny because I know what happens. Wilson. Damn straight, me. It's just so beautiful. I only played like 10 minutes. Look out. 8 more miles still. Well, best part of climbing over it. Okay. Just nice. Beautiful. 1982. During the summer, you and Julia enjoyed walking buckets at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from far away places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Lovely. Maybe dog, Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking. When she is stressed, you confront the attacker. You scare him away. You beat his goddamn face. Your arms get cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry, your eyes out before the cops show up. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay, you don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You obviously do not convince her to drop. You ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you want to. You tell her not to pass it up if it's what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in a stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. You make macaroni and drink and forget about it. It works. You watch Dallas on TV and sleep together on the couch. It's just so beautiful. Here comes the beautiful picture. Bucket is getting older, and Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to university. I'm not looking for a bit, though. I'm not going to read it. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in her class. Her in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by police. She's devastated. She's sent home by on permanent medical leave. Some days you get Julie who calls you a dope, and your unborn children are idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family that they are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while your friends come by with little things, so by another day she gets worse. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the second between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with a 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You're determined to take care of her by yourself. I'd rather move her into a full-time care home so that way she can... That's weird. My mouse did that. Look how beautiful this is. The furthest I've got is to the tower, so I ain't missed much. Beautiful. Lily. Her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day. than every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, if you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I'll cut off your balls off. You slowly decide not to see your old friends that much. Julia, sister Susan, moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go her some other time? Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you that you use it. If you won't see a therapist, you won't. You always really like Susan. Yeah, right, that sounded more sarcastic. Alright. Months go by. Not reading that. Julia doesn't remember him well, and you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less, and seeing her less and less makes her forget you more. You think summer is coming, and you see an ad in the papers for a job. The reason why I don't want to read Bucket Die, because I don't like anything to do with animals dying, and I just hit my mic. Take it. I just don't like anything like that. I just don't. Enter the lookout tower. Well, here we are. This is where I got to before I realized I wasn't recording. It's like, damn it. So I had to restart my game. Oh well. Let's just begin, shall we? I got to about here and then I noticed. Oh well. Look how beautiful it is. Turn on the power. Okay, where's the power? Would it be this red light? Oh, generator switch. Can I hit it again?
Wow. Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Oh, radio. That's a pike.
Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Oh, come on. Pick up radio.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
You kill three ex-husbands, you're rebelling against mom, nobody back home can stand you.
Okay, you've killed three husbands. You're a black widow and you're just out here until the heat dies down and then you'll kill again.
Ooh, very good. Bravo, Henry.
Okay, I sleep now?
Not quite. Now you.
Okay, good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
Welcome to the job. Firewatch. Day one. One loading screen later. Oh, here we go.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
All I can do is pick up radio.
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, 14 hours of sleep? Oof.
Huh? Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's
right, so
6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Oh.
Are those fucking fireworks?
Where? Hey. Oh.
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Whoa. That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight.
Oh.
Kick the shit out of him sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
What? I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich.
What?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
Oh, that is so brilliant dialogue. Alright, I know odds to run because I read the instructions. Let's hope I'm going the right way because I'm not bothered to check the map. Can I continue running? Oh cool, I don't have to change. Oh yeah. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just running. Oh, supply box.
I found the supply box.
Great!
Oh god, can I just use the number? Oh, I can! Ooh yeah! What's this?
Hey, I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Armless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type. Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
People just stuff these things with old food? That's how you get bears.
Those boxes are bear-proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
I don't think a wooden box is bear-proof. To be fair. Right, let's go. Oh, that's beautiful. Just look at that. Ooh, what's this?
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
No, Henry, that's life.
Christ, lady. This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
It should be called Cripple Gulch, just east of Gonna Pee in a Bag Forever Flats.
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description.
Oh, I go down. I thought you were going to just repel it. Oh, well. Where am I going to go? I can't tell.
No.
Ouch. Oh.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Cripple Gulch got me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
Think you'll have to pee in a bag for the rest of your life?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
That is awesome. Oh, they caught me there.
Wow, there's a big rock outcropping down here near the lake. It's really something.
Yeah, makes for good camping. There used to be a group of guys who would boulder out there a couple times a year.
What happened to them?
Don't know. Just stopped coming out.
This is so cool, just looking at this. Beautiful, man.
I'm staring at the big outcropping down here, but I'm not quite sure where to look for our pyrotechnicians.
Ken's?
Maybe keep heading west toward the lake.
Are you serious?
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
Oh,
are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
I would like to retract my statement about knuckle sandwiches. Feet away.
Awesome. Ooh, rucksacks. I'll put that fire in there.
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Can I talk about the whiskey? No? Save for later.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Are you serious?
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
There's a... ooh.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies, same as anyone, but there's, you know...
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay. I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy, enjoy dealing with that.
You gotta take it easy with the fireworks, all right?
You ought to take it easy at the Sizzler buffet.
But Chelsea?
What? He's just some loose rat in the woods. I mean, he's grody.
You don't know a damn thing about me.
We know you're a peeping Tom. How long have you been standing over there?
Oh my God, is that what you are? Work me out.
Ew.
Can we just get out of here? You're just some sad man out in the woods.
Right.
Hey, that go okay?
It went fine. Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Excellent. So, I guess it's this way. Oh, it's beautiful. Look here. Ooh, I want to walk in the river. Can I jump off here? Oh, I can. Wow. Love. Oh, I want to go under the rock.
Yeah. So, I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
This looks beautiful, it says.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
Oh, God.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe? God.
Ah! Bloody God. Ooh, okay.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So
I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
Hello? It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Oh, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it!
I bless the rains down in Africa! This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first. Although, Demi says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
God damn it! Does he? Cave closed. This bad, man. Climbing up the rocks. Oh.
There's some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something I...
What is it?
Something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Not when they're kind of alone. Don't say hi or hello. They just stand there. Oh, here we go. Ooh, I never noticed this sign. What's the sign say? Trail closed sign. Okay. You fell.
Damn it. Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime.
Ooh, what's this? Wooden sign.
Ah! You know, I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
What kind of name is Forrest Burns, anyway?
Well, that would be a pun, Hank. A glorious pun.
I went to junior high with a guy named Royal Butts.
Royal?
Butts.
I didn't think anyone had been named Royal since the 1850s.
No, they haven't.
Well, Royal's mom, Flo, was a bit of a trendsetter.
Flo Butts? Oh, man, that's even worse.
Yeah, well, it's still better than Forrest Burns. So it's, just the outhouse, then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one, at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
Okay. There you go. Stay in it. His legs pitch.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here?
Yep. It doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never.
Oh my god. I love this game.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me. Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
My fucking sheets are gone.
They stole your sheets? That's just mean.
Yeah, it sucks.
What was it?
The place is trashed.
Okay, I put in a call.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
I think it was that guy
Maybe
in the canyon.
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it, and... Now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm going to call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Just point me to the Forest Service weapons cache and I'll feel safer than the Pope in his little car.
Yeah, someone made the choice years ago that leaving people with infinite amounts of alone time and a gun was kind of a bad idea.
Grenades?
I'll see what I can do.
All right, you're by my station. Yep, that's the way of life. That's how you live. Chuck grenades at him. Hey, Jay, we did him alone. Cueing his awesome scream.
Wake up.
I'm up.
Hey, wake up.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
So you're going to want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Is it?
Okay, all right.
No, it's not as well. Call me Hank. My name is Henry. Get out of my way, Trey. You're filing in Firewatch business. Here's this way, yeah, here we go. Alright, remember, go to your toilet. Oh, Jesus! What? Look at the jumping animation. It looks like he might break his leg. Where his leg's bloody position. Hey! Run, 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 as fast as I can. Run, 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 as fast as I can. Gotta go back to Jonesy Lake. Do, 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 do. Beautiful. Keep it going. That's it.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
Oh, that's cool.
What did you get up to down there?
I mean,
what's life like?
I don't know. I used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Oh, does that work? Oh,
hey, I don't think so. Why, have you?
I don't know if it is.
Okay, good. No, I don't think he has
any
idea.
Hey, your button is still down.
I'm absolutely
Delilah,
sure.
Delilah, I can hear you.
Would you?
I said I could... Wait, are you talking about me?
All right. I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife? Or like she's taken half my stuff wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
What's that? Yeah. Old outhouse, yes.
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
This is an old castle.
Found an old hat from a Korean War vet.
You'd be surprised how many former service members take this gig.
Well, makes sense.
I imagine if you've been through war, you probably can't get enough silence.
Anything I should know about the cabin at the top of this hill? Hello?
Oh.
Okay, then.
Was this straight on the fire? Is that, ooh, yeah, that take this guitar? I can examine it. Go back. Oh, someone's gonna jump out at me as soon as I open this. No. False jump scare. That would have been an awesome jump scare. You know, just like a raccoon, it just jumps out and runs out the window. That would be kind of cool. Let's leave this area. Back on the path again. It's a lovely game. Alright, so I guess I gotta go this way. Yeah, this way. There we go. I don't know when we're running, can't you? Oh god. Running into trees and bushes. Genius. What was that? Oh, was that me? Probably. Ooh, cash drop. I'm pretty sure some of that is not me that's moving around. Where's that drop gun? What's this?
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a, Turt Reynolds.
Yes.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
Oh, you tell him I love Cannonball Run.
Thank you. Copy the map.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Okay. Let's go. Oh yeah, I meant to be following the cable. Oops. Oh, are you serious?
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Hey, oh. Is that been cut? Cause...
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around.
Oh, so that... Oh, is it gone? Is it gone? Oh,
hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
Go to her.
Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. This way. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Good. Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I'm gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Ooh, is that
another big into Red Eagle.
What is that? It's a backpack.
Great.
I it was a backpack.
See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Moving in.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
I didn't get to read the name.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
Was he a ranger or something?
Oh, no. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago.
Hmm.
Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and, one day they were just gone. It sucks. Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
Right.
Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
So is that this one? I'm going the wrong way. And I'm going the wrong way. I'm going straight into a bush. Genius, Chris. Genius.
What does she have?
She's got Alzheimer's. Dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
Imagine that.
And for you.
That and then forgetting
anyway, it. Everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
It would be nice if Henry was able to say something then. Like saying thanks or something like that. Instead of being silent. Whew. Oh, what's this?
Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No. I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh, yeah. You should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
Okay, get some time here. Up we go. This isn't the way I had to go, is it? Column of smoke is straight ahead of me. Okay, let's go straight then. Right, so it seems it's to the right of me, so I have to keep going. Right, so I'm heading towards it, that's good. Yeah, that's probably why they were close to the lake, because, you know, the tent's just there.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I walked over and asked her what her major was, because I thought she was a student, not a prof.
Smooth.
That's me. I did make the first move, though.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk. I'm down by Cripple Gulch.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to 5 Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
Yep. I think that's probably... Is that the longest drop? Probably. Alright, so the thin layer of smoke was this way? There it is. What's this? Ah, is this how I get down? Yes, it is! This is where I got to go, isn't it? Yes, this is probably it. Spacebar, rappel. Gotta keep going, gotta keep going, gotta keep going, gotta keep going. Gotta keep going, going up to the line of light. This game is just beautiful. Is this the way I gotta go? Wow, this area is clear. Oh, cash box. So beautiful. Oh, what's this? Missing person.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Wow.
Well, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire.
Awesome.
Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Excellent. This game is just beautiful. Proceed using... Oh, it's always been there. Oh my god, I can take pictures.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
They went that way, didn't they? Because that looks like... Yeah, it's just rocks. Alright, where are you? Show yourself! Aha!
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. These girls have a full case of beer left here.
Wow.
A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like... I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines.
Can I even pick up my sheets, please?
Maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback. Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
We're going to find the police.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
Let me know what it says.
About how you creeped us in the leg and didn't stay... Oh!
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
They're threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this. Okay, someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Me too.
When summer actually comes, day three. Don't even warn you that they're gonna change games. They just change without you knowing. Just like screen fade, go into a new world, into a new darkness, new life. Yes. Oh, I'm building up my window.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
What?
Why are you asking?
Where are you?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
You can't say I'm white.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
I don't know, think about tuxes.
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
That.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, Dale, yes. Now tell me about your face. Awesome. I'm looking at you across the bar.
Can't see
what
me.
What do I see?
Why am I taking wood? Big beard, my nose is broken.
Well, I have a thin mustache, real thin mustache. I got a long scar, goes down across my eye and down my cheek.
And you only wear tuxes?
Yeah.
Are you a freaking Bond villain?
I get up to some stuff, yeah.
I don't think you're taking this very seriously. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're steely.
Yeah, steely.
Cold hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
And yes, I can build my window. Are you using nails? No. You just magically just put boards on, no nails. I'm wizard people. You don't need no nails.
I got that window all patched up. So what should I do now? What's next?
What's next?
Yeah.
What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
No, never.
Oh.
I'm going to keep running.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Sarcastic bastards.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Thank you. You sarcastic person. What about day four? You just skipped a nine? Wow. I wish it was like a slow fade. It'd be a lot better, it'd be cooler, it'd be realistic, you know. Instead of like, day, some whatever day, day negative one. Ooh. Oh, this picture is, this is an awesome.
Hello, Henry.
Picture.
Having a nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing.
Oh.
They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week.
The two girls.
They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
I'm sorry.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
It's worth mentioning.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
True.
Yeah.
Don't hide secrets.
I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Thank you. Oh, it's beautiful. Take a picture quickly. No! Oh well, I can take screenshots of my recordings, so that is fine. Excellent. Yes. Yes. Day 15. Let us begin, shall we?
Henry. Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Hey, Delilah, I don't know why you're asking me to come out this late.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know.
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Wow, I sound so caring. Pen. Just literally pen at the end. And did we just skip so many days? Justin, did we just skip 18 days? Because we were the 15th. Now we're the 35th. Three days. What am I doing? Am I going for a supply drop or full faith?
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair?
Yes.
Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes,
jerky.
You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6! She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Wait, what do you mean, find
him? So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I am.
Good. I'm glad.
Oh, God.
Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette.
Ooh.
And...
Gillette?
For some reason. I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me.
Oh.
I came out here, I lied, and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
You didn't fuck up.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
Oh. Let's be good.
All right. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Bert Reynolds. You get confused with him, remember? Day 64, wow, we've done a massive jump from 33. We've gone now 31 days ahead now. The days are getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Is it going to keep going? Also, does anyone want to play Nintendo 64? Oh, God.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm going to call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but... I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And She doesn't have a name yet.
Ooh.
I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
How about Delilah?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Why not?
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
Yeah.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink.
Wow, that's quite smart.
I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You would like it there.
If I was there with you, I'm sure I would like it a lot.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
Oh.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I thought it was saying, can it say like it's spreading or something? But
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
Good. I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way.
Ooh.
I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
Oh, fuck it.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know.
Brother Pedro. Need it.
What? What can we do?
Wait.
Well, let me tell you.
Is it do anything? Oh, day in. Change. 12 days later. Let's go. Is it 12? It's 12. Yay, 12 days later. Yay. Ow. That was my head.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Put it away.
No. I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Oh, hey.
That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. Hmm? See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What?
It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Oh, freaking... Woo! Am I dead?
Henry, are you there?
No, I'm alive.
What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold-cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be
God
a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
Why would I make this up? It's an insane lie at worst, and a shitty prank at best.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
No, they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship... Friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who.
Okay.
What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation.
Yes.
Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked.
Yeah.
I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres. Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Yeah.
Okay. I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Oh, shit.
I don't know how long I can stick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in 2 shakes. They might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Where are they? Oh, I didn't like the sound of that. But a scout camp there. Alright, I gotta go back to the lookout. Is that away? I don't know that sound. A bit, and I'm going up. I'm freaking away. Keep it going. Go the right way for once, Chris. Keep it going. That's kind of cool, though. What? What hit space? That string's kind of broke. Little string broke. It's kind of a bit glitchy there, isn't it? Alright, so I gotta go back to my camp. Let's go. Don't believe I got suckered punched in the back of the head. It's stupid. And I was playing some music. Nice relaxing music. Okay. Makes no sense. And also, did you notice that robot looks like a dick? I name you Dick Canyon. I find it. Klein. Thank you. I did that, but whoops. Keep it going.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Intercepting? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
I do like the fact in this game you can make chemistry between Delilah and Henry. But, to be fair...
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the good ones. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
I don't think the second option
is a good
option. No,
you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Alright, so where am I now? Where do I have to go to the camp? I just came from the north, so, oh, just straight ahead. Okay, makes sense. This way then. Straight towards June Fire. 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 I used to say that as a kid. Anyway, as I was saying, you can choose chemistry between Delilah and Henry, it seems. But I don't believe they'll end up with each other due to the fact of the way how, like, you both have your betrayals and then you still have Jules and you're still alive. It's not sort of right to do that, so I don't think you'll end up, to be fair. Unless I'm mistaken, you can actually. I don't think it will happen. My thoughts, but, you know.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks, now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on, that one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay, that's how wound up all this shit has me.
Whoa. Someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but...
Okay.
Given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond.
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den. Or you know, anywhere.
Did you steal it? Oh. Is it?
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware weebelos in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers. The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm going to walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Is that what this is? This seems high. Bingo.
Talk to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, marching
I
band?
I like the time bar.
Oh, no. Like comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragons armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good. Okay. Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up. I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss. Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
What do we get out of it?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Fuck that!
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Right.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are. At least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
Alright, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Stop! Stop me before I open the supply catch. How dare you? Next day. going to the next day. Oh, shame he didn't give me a few seconds. I could have opened that supply catch and got the map up free. If it's there.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the 50th time today.
Oh, I brought the game then.
The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
You can do me for a trip out of here. I don't care if it's on horseback or a helicopter or in a canoe. Just get me out of here.
Henry, we have work left to do. Let's chat about what's bothering you and you'll feel better.
Are you serious?
Let's talk. Okay?
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
Is that this?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Oh, wow. I'm an idiot. That torch I picked up, I didn't realize I had it. Oh, I'm here. Okay. So, where is it? Oh, it's where I was. Was that where I was opening that cash drop? Damn it. Alright, where is my toilet? Opposite my toilet. There you go. And go over this way. See? The toilet helps all. Tell you which direction you gotta go. I could use my compass, but I ain't bothered to. I'm just gonna use the toilet. My direction. My toilet is facing north. I can just use my power, my toilet, to give me the direction. The direction. Yes. Let's, Okay. Wait, here's a question. What happens if that guy, or whoever is tailing me, or whatever is tailing me, hasn't got one of them charts with him, so he can know where I'm going? You don't know, you could be tailing me right now without me even knowing. Right, so let's enough chit chat and let's actually get there. That tree looks freaking awesome. Keep doing that. I keep holding shift. Oh, I couldn't tell if I was running then. Alright, let's open that thing now that I'm here. So what do you want me to do?
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it.
I'm right in front of
it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Oh, really?
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Right. Can't access it. Oh. 5678. I'm getting nothing. I'm not getting a mouse thing. Oh.
I've got it now.
spent all day getting you that radio.
Thanks.
I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Yeah,
hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry, we have to get into that site.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
You know that I'm scared. None of it makes any sense.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no, this isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking. I just changed clothes laying on the floor because I don't know who could be watching.
Look, I'm headed back to the gate, and now that I've got an axe, we'll know something soon.
You need to get into that site. Call me when you find something. Hey, I just thought of something not great.
What?
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
No, you talked to it in math.
Oh, shit.
My thoughts exactly.
Our radios were tapped. And now someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Did I just...
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
Keep going the wrong way. Okay, it's this way. God damn, I'm an idiot. Idiot, yo. Here we go. Now I'm going the right way.
I just heard something.
What is it?
I don't know. It was goddamn terrifying, though.
Well, it could be an elk, or it could be someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Fuck.
How about you don't do that again?
Okay, let's keep going. Beautiful. So, the whole game now has a new gender. Instead of it just being beautiful, it's all horrific story. Great. Love it. I'm gonna have to end this part here, guys. This is a whole entire part. I think I've gone over just like an hour and a half, something like that. Something close to that. So, yeah. It's gonna be a big episode, and hopefully I can get it done in 2 episodes. I haven't gone this way yet. Is this gonna take me the same way? Oh, cash box. Excellent. I'm stuck in a bush. Excellent. What the fuck? I've got no reptile. For some reason my mouse isn't popping up. Nothing's popping up. What on earth? Alright. I guess I'm gonna have to reload my game, so I guess this could be the end of the episode. So yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed part one, and we'll hopefully be completing this, because apparently the game's only 2 hours long. So I'll be able to complete it in the next section. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you when I restart. Bye bye.